Melissa Armo, she's the owner of educational firm, the stock Swoosh. Melissa, when we first started talking to you, the Dow was down 1,500 points. Now it's recovered half of that amount. What's your takeaway from that?
I would say that if we close strong today, which we still got about almost a half an hour left, if we close over where we opened at the beginning of the year 2018, that's a good sign for the short term here in the next couple of days. We could do that. We're right there, you know, above it slightly right now, even with the drop off today. So we look for that number. If anybody's looking at the Dow, if you're looking at the spiders, look to see where we open the calendar year and see if we can close right around that number or above it today. That would be a good sign for right now, the next couple of days. But as far as the rally here into the close, I'm not surprised about it at all, because like I said, I think this is profit taking and a buying opportunity for some people who are looking at long term ahead, not just the next week, but the rest of 2018 and even beyond. Remember, it's not just 2018. If you're a long term investor, then it doesn't matter if you have one or two down days, even like we've had in the last 48 hours. If you're a short-term day trader, or if you do overnights where you're in and out in swing trades, well, obviously then you would have wanted to get out Friday when things started dropping, or you got out before that, or you got out maybe even in December or November. The market power trended all of this year and all of last year. Something is not going to go in a straight line up forever and ever and ever. That's not realistic. You will have pullbacks in the market. Wait until the market gaps up again in the morning, which could happen, like I said, in the next week or the next two, and see and watch how it acts between now and then if you want to wait to get back in. But aggressive people will probably buy this into the close today, to be honest with you.
Okay, so yeah, Melissa, to that point, you know, obviously a fool's errand to try to time the market in the big picture. I mean, it's very difficult to be successful in doing that. But we could have said the same thing after Friday's loss, a sell-off of 666 points on the Dow. That was a buying opportunity. So my question for you is, how do we know when this sell-off reaches bottom?
You wait till the market gaps up. That's what I look at. I look at gaps. Market gapped down today, and it tried to hold itself in the morning the first 30 minutes, and it couldn't do it. It started dropping, and then you saw all the red. We gapped down Friday. We sold off. Wait till the market gaps up. Don't buy into support. We're into support. We were into support on Friday. So you're right. If people bought on Friday, they were down this morning into the open, but the market gapped down Friday. That's not a time to buy. You don't buy support. You wait till the market gaps up, which is a bullish sign that institutions are buying in the pre-market, in the post-market. And that's what you want to see. You want to see that sign. And I wouldn't be surprised if you see that one day in the next couple of days or the next 2 weeks. And one of the people that was just on mentioned about 2016, how we opened very bearish in the year. Guess what? We did. And we recovered within 2 weeks of that and then took off from there and never looked back. Never even looked back at that $200 level or around 190, 200, but since we rallied over it. So it took 2 weeks, that's it, and we recovered. So the sell-offs in the last 2 days could be recovered very quickly. And here's why, okay? It's not just technically, even though technically we're still very strong. The reason is the market to sell off, we have to have something that would create people wanting to sell. That would be a panicky reaction, like, for example, something to happen with North Korea. Sure. I mean, God forbid that would happen, but to be honest with you, we are all looking at ourselves and we're talking today, well, why is this happening?
Right.
We can make five reasons why maybe it's happening, but really there's nothing like we're saying, oh my God, it's the end of the world. No, I mean, there really isn't any reason. It's profit taking and we're going to recover soon. If there was a reason, there was a reason you could stick your hand and say, oh my gosh, this is, you know, terrible, then I could see a continuation of the sell-off, but there really isn't. And we're trying to figure it out. We're like, oh, why? Because people are just up and they're taking profits.
No one really ever knows with these things. Melissa, I want to ask you the same question we asked on Petrides, which is what advice you would have for the average investor here on a day like today?
On a day like today, don't look at anything. If you're in it for the long term, don't look at anything and turn off the TV. But because you're going to panic. You're going to panic because you're going to see yourself being up a set amount of money and now you're not up as much.
Right.
If you're down and you want to get out, you want to get out. But if you were that concerned about being down, then you should have got out when you were up 2 weeks ago or the beginning of 2018. If you're a long-term investor, don't look at anything. Turn off the TV and go out about your day because these kinds of things happen.
Yep.
And by long-term, I mean 5 years, 10 years, retirement accounts, you know, 401ks, don't look at stuff. If you're a day trader, you could be shorting this. I wouldn't short it, but you could be shorting this today and making money to the short side. And you cover all your long positions in the last 48 hours, and you'd wait and get back in. So
yeah, and maybe if we see
trade tomorrow.
Right, maybe and maybe if we see more buying here, we might have an indication of covering some short positions. John, I don't know if you're still with us. Here, but yeah. But if you are, I want to get your reaction to what Melissa said there. You basically are on the same page. If you're a day trader, today was probably not a good day for you if you didn't have your positions placed on the right bets here. And if you are looking for the long term, especially if you're diversified and you've got money in different asset classes, and you're seeing these yields go up here in the bond market, you might have had an okay day. But at what point, though, John, should we start to get concerned? This is day two now of the Dow dropping here, S&P erasing all losses. So what happens tomorrow? What happens on Wednesday?
Yeah, I mean, without a crystal ball, there are three things we don't know. Well, we know when a market sells off that a market will sell off at some point in time. We just don't know for how long and how much. So it always comes back to what's the fundamentals of the business that you're buying into, and what are you willing to pay for that? And when you have a sell-off in a stock of a company that's very strong, you know, then that's a great buying opportunity if the underlying fundamentals of the business are good, right?
Right.
I mean, that's the key here.
And I do want to ask you about that because, you know, you're talking about us sitting here, standing here on a rainy day, but the fundamentals are good. What are those fundamentals that you think are strong?
Sure. So does a company have more cash than debt on its balance sheet? How much free cash flow does the underlying business generate, which is, income minus capital expenditures? Does the company reinvest that cash into its business in a smart way? Is the company's top line growing, their revenue growing? Are they only growing their earnings by buying back stock and because of a tax rebate? You know, how healthy is the underlying business? And, does the sell-off allow you to buy it at a more attractive price? You know, I know, you know, what was mentioned in the Cheddar 50 is NVIDIA. Mm-hmm. You know, NVIDIA has been one of the great stocks in the S&P 500 over the past 2 years, and it's getting shellacked today. Well, if you liked NVIDIA's prospects, by the way, we don't own NVIDIA, nor do I personally, but if you like the prospects of NVIDIA, well, you shouldn't be fearful just because the
right.
stock is down, you know, whatever it is today. You should be greedy because you think the underlying potential is so much more attractive, and today presents a great buying opportunity for you. So, you know, that's the key. The key is, you know, do you want to pay $400,000 for a Ferrari or $200,000 for a Ferrari? You want to buy it at a cheaper price for that business that is like a fast-growing Ferrari.
Yeah, we'll see if these fundamentals still hold. We have a lot of earnings this week, Snap, Disney reporting. We want to thank our roundtable here today, Melissa Armo, owner of educational firm The Stock Swoosh, and friend of the show here, John Petrides, the managing director and portfolio manager over at Point View Wealth Management. Thank you both for joining us today.